everybody. Happy Friday. Whew, I just got home from work. And I'm pouring me some wine. And I need me a cigarette. Because, oh boy, I've never wanted a cigarette so much in my whole entire life as I want a cigarette right now. Oh my god. I have a feeling I'm gonna be a huge smoker again. No bueno. Alright guys. Forgive me if this video was like freaking Star Wars saga. Alright. Today is second day of work, but officially it's like the first day of work. Because orientation doesn't really count. I didn't really do anything but, you know, sit and watch information. So, I wasn't actually supposed to be working today or tomorrow. Today is Friday. I wasn't supposed to be working Thursday or Friday or Saturday, just Saturday, and then Monday on. But the manager, they need people over there at the store, and they want to hurry up and get me in there. They want to train me as quickly as possible because they really need me to work. So they decided that I should get to know the computer system and the registers better. So what better way to do it than work a weekend? So I was very nervous to go to work today. My baby's godmother got my daughter today, and she's gonna get her tomorrow and Saturday, and I'm just grateful, and I love this woman, and I'm gonna give her a pedicure and freaking anoint her feet, and I don't care because she's big on pedicure, so I will give her a pedicure and freaking rub scented oil on them bitches. I don't care. I adore this woman right now for A, giving me the job, B, being my friend, and C, being a great godmother to my kid and being so trustworthy. I didn't have anyone to take care of my kid. I'm not supposed to be working these kind of hours. I worked from 5 o'clock in the afternoon until midnight, almost 12:30. And I've been on my feet for 7 straight hours. I didn't get a break at all. I'm supposed to get 2 15-minute breaks. I did not get a break. The only time I got a break and I didn't even really get a break was, oh my god, and I'm going to tell my friend that. Because, okay, I'm sorry guys, but let me go to this thing because now I'm gonna forget. Remind me that I'm supposed to text my friend. The only time I got a break was when I went to the bathroom at 10:30 at night to use the bathroom, and I think I was away from the register for like 3 minutes tops that I had a moment to myself. I didn't eat today. I didn't get a chance to eat. This morning I woke up. I had a shake. I had a granola bar, a yummy peanut butter one. Oh my god, how delicious. And I also had a tuna sandwich with plenty of eggs in it. I wish I had wheat bread, but I have white bread, but still. Actually, I had, yeah, a tuna sandwich, and it was okay. I wanted to eat today at work. I was going to have, like, a banana because they have fresh fruits there. And, which is good. They have a lot of fresh fruits. And I think that's what I'm going to do, like, because I see people around the job. You know, because they're standing around all day. You know what they do? They grab, like, sodas and chips and things. I'm going to grab a fruit cup, or I'm going to grab, something else and eat like that. I'm not going to be like them and munching on random nonsense, because that's how the weight comes back on. Mm-mm. My weight is really bad today. I am at the highest maintaining weight allowed by me that I'm okay with. I can't go over this number. If I start going over this number, that's it. I'm gonna start panicking, and then the eating disorder is just gonna have to. The eating disorder is gonna really dominate my personality. So I'm hoping that I can be okay with this and not panic too much. But I didn't get a chance to eat. I was gonna have a banana. I brought a fiber bar, and I even brought like some pretzels to snack on. But I didn't get a break. Everyone else did, but not me. I'm the new girl, so. I get to work. I was supposed to, I'm supposed to text my friend. I'm supposed to text her because I went to the bathroom. They're not supposed to punch me out when I go to the bathroom, but this manager that was on there, he kept punching me out when I went to the bathroom. Like, what the fuck? And I only went to the bathroom one time. He's not supposed to do that, but he did it anyway. Fucker. Please remind me to tell my friend that. Okay, so I was anxious. I was really freaked out. I got to work. I have this problem where, I'm not sure if there's an actual term for it. I don't know. Where, okay. God, I need more alcohol. Like if you explain something to me, I won't get it. Like for instance, I was in orientation and I'm looking at all these things and I'm reading everything and I'm not retaining the information. I'm very forgetful. I have to write things down. If I'm at a doctor's office and the doctor's explaining all these things to me, like, yes, because you have this, and I'm nodding my head like, oh my God, yes, yes. Mm-hmm. When I get out of that doctor's office, I'm not going to remember anything. And I don't remember the doctor's name. I could barely remember what he looks like. I don't know. I have trouble retaining information like that. But if you were to show me something, if I'm hands-on doing something, then I can remember. So today was one of those hands-on things. Today the manager took me to the register. There was someone else there. This guy. And he was showing me very quickly everything. And as quick as the information was and I felt really overwhelmed, I picked it up. So today I fucking rocked. I did really, really well. I did really, really well. And I was very friendly, I was very outgoing, I was happy. There was a smile on my face constantly. My God, today was fantastic. I never interacted with so many people and just had so much positive feedback from like everybody, you know. It was great. The boy next to me was supposed to like train me. He didn't do a thing, but then again, I didn't need to. And God, he was just like miserable with his job. I hope I don't be like that like 4 months down the line and shit, but there's this other manager at the company, this woman, and she's very bitter. She's just one of those kind of managers that doesn't care. For instance, there were people coming. There's a lot of sales going on at the store. So there were people coming confused with coupons and not wondering why the register didn't ring up what the savings were saying and things like that. And so this very, I don't know even what to call her. Let's call her Doldrums, my goodness, because she's like down in the doldrums. So doldrum lady comes and she gives people attitude. She's like very miserable. I'm like, oh, she's one of those people. This company I work for encourages you to be friendly with the customers. They encourage you to be hands-on, helpful. This is what I learned in my orientation, that I could pick up like the videos. Just a second, this is my baby. I'm sorry, guys. Hold on, honey. I'm vlogging. So, they encourage you to be hands-on. Now, there's this other guy there at the register. There's not a lot of people. There were three men that needed my help. They didn't know where things were. I knew to the store, but I didn't know where things were. But I shopped there, so I kind of knew where stuff was. And so, I left my register and I went and I showed the people. Oh, they're like, oh, where's this? And I said, well, it's an aisle this, but let me show you. So I went with them. I took them. They didn't know what they wanted. There was this one guy who was looking for medicine. He didn't know what medicine was best, and I kind of knew what he wanted. And this other guy, and my God, if you would have seen me, I was like the epitome of fucking generosity and helpfulness. And I did that, and I felt so great helping these people. By the time these people left the store, I was at the register already, you know, taking care of other people. They flagged me down. Hi. Oh, they knew my name. They said goodbye. A huge smile on their face. You don't know how good that makes me feel. Doldrums doesn't like that. Down in the Doldrums manager is like, listen, you're not supposed to leave your register. I told my friend this. My friend took me to work and picked me up, my baby's godmother. I told her this. I'm like, listen, I'm sorry, you know, I don't want to get in trouble or anything, but maybe tomorrow they'll tell you that I left the register to help these three people. She's like, that's exactly what you're supposed to do. I'm like, well, this other manager, Doldrums, told me that I was not supposed to do that. So my baby's godmother didn't like that, and she's going to have a talk with her tomorrow. I'm not trying to get anybody in trouble, but I'm not trying anybody to get me in trouble, you understand? It's not going to happen like that. So other than that, I didn't have really much of a problem with anyone today. This other manager, he was just really scatterbrained, but he was a good guy. I worked a lot, my feet hurt, but it was great. I'm glad, and I get to do it all over again tomorrow, so I'm happy. Tomorrow I have to work more hours. Let me see, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7, 8, 8 to 9, 9 to 10, 7 to 11, 12. Tomorrow's 9 hours I have to be on my feet, and I don't even know if they're going to give me a break or what. But I'm happy. It's different over there. Being at the register, I had 3 guys tell me that my name, my real name now, it's very unique. They haven't, you don't hear my name much, and they like my name. They're like, you're unforgettable, trust me, a name like that you're gonna remember. I had people hit on me today. I had people compliment me on my hair. I had people, oh my god, it was just like really, really friendly. And it was nice though. I didn't have time for the eating disorder. I didn't have time for anxiety. I just had time to work and focus. And I think that's great. I met the head pharmacist who's gonna train me. He is a sweetheart. He loves to text and put winky faces at the end of the text. I think it's so cute. And he's like, look, I'm really looking forward to working with you. I'm going to train you. You're going to be great. Yes, it's a lot of work. It's a lot of things you have to learn in a, you know, a little bit amount of time. But I have a great feeling about you that you're going to get this. And I think so, too. I'm going to try my best to get this done. So my kid, I hope I can see my kid more. I haven't seen her all week, basically. And, but my first paycheck, don't tell her, I'm gonna get her a Nintendo Wii, but shh, don't say nothing. I can't wait. She's so happy. She's like, mommy, did you make a lot of money today? Did you help a lot of people today? Did you make, she thinks like, you know, cause my uniform is supposed to wear like a lab coat and stuff, cause I'm in the pharmacy. So she thinks I make the medicine, you know. So she's like, did you help a lot of people? Did you save a lot of lives? Oh, pobrecita. She's so innocent. She has no idea about things. But she's really proud of me. And that's all that matters. I'm officially a working mother. I never thought I would get to this point. I always thought I would be a stay-at-home mom. And that would be with, like, a husband that works and takes care of me and the family. But it's okay to work. It's okay to be a working mom. It's good. Think to be a role model for your kid and to show your kid that, you know, sometimes you have to be the one to be the head of the household, so that's fine. So tomorrow more work. I feel okay. It's gonna be a little bit challenging at times, but I think I'm up for it. And I miss my boyfriend. I haven't seen him. It's gonna be on 3 weeks. We were supposed to see each other Friday, and now we can't. Now we have to see each other next week, and have to work next week when we're gonna see each other. So it's like less time. So I don't know. I have to be a mom and an employee and a girlfriend, and I have to be all these things, and I don't know how to balance the time. So it's gonna be challenging, but. The most important thing is that everything that I have right now is things that I want in my life for long term. My daughter is long term. I want to last in this job. I want to move up in this company. I want to be with my boyfriend forever. I love this man. I'm ready to move on and make whatever serious choices we have to make together. I would love to do that. He's a great guy. He encourages me to not be so consumed with the eating disorder. He, you know, wants me to be healthy and be good, and I feel strong when he's around. I feel like I want to get better for him, for myself. And I never wanted to get better for myself, but I feel like I have a reason to get better for myself, to be better in general, so... So yeah, but a good first, second day of work overall, yeah. So that's it, guys. I'm gonna go finish my drink, have another cigarette. Oh my god, the reason why I wanted to smoke a cigarette so bad is because that's all people were buying, with like fucking cigarettes. Oh my god. Cigarettes and soda. I never wanted cigarettes and soda so much in my life today. God. So that's it. I'm gonna go. I hope you're all well, and we'll talk again tomorrow. Good night.